पूरा ओके ना? The congruent parts first and then go into the finer aspect. Sa re ga ga. And what matches this in the Uttaranga is sa re ga ga, and to match that ma pa da da da. So ma pa da is exactly the same as sa re ga. Sa re ga ma pa da sa re ga ga ga, and then it continues. Three sa re ga ma pa's following each other. Sa re ga ma pa, sa re ga ma pa, sa re ga ma pa, ma pa da ni sa, sa re ga ma pa da ni sa. So this is the beauty of it. You know, you have absolutely identical structures falling onto each other, and then you can go on making designs which match up. And you saw one such beautiful harkat done by Ghulam Ali right in the beginning of his ghazal. So this is the first thing. The second part, very fascinating about Darbari in particular, is, you know, in the Raj, to establish this symmetry or the congruity between the first half and the second half of the sapta, you need a fulcrum, you need an axis of symmetry. Now, Darbari is one such rag where both the pancham and the madhyam are prominent, but the axis of symmetry is on the madhyam, not on the pancham. So, what matches sarega is mapadha and not padhani. This is really, really, really wonderful. And that is what, you know, presents a completely different landscape when it comes to expanding the mind. So this is about the content of the mind. Now let us look closely. Why is Darbari, you know, so revered? And what? Why is Darbari, why does this rag inspire such an awe amongst both the artists and the listeners? For the artist, mastering the swara positions is extremely, extremely difficult. And you really have to, you know, struggle all your life. You know, you have to be at it, and then you start getting the... Because these things are important if you really have to establish and use that congruity, that symmetry. And so, you know, isko ustad unka raag. Now this is the rag of really, really the senior musicians, you know, who really aspire to reach out. So that is Darbari. So now let us look closely exactly why, you know, this swara positions is so difficult. Now I hope you will excuse me. I have not spent enough time with this rag. For a flautist particularly, this rag is extremely, extremely difficult. So I am going to try and explain what I need to say, and I hope I am able to come up to it, and I will try to sing out this rag also whenever I can. So this is the beginning. As we said, sa re ga, when the Gandhar comes from the Madhyam and when it is attached to the rail, so in the Arohi movement, Sarega, this Gandhar is closer to the rail. Sarega, and the Devat match is with Sarega, Nida, Sarega. But when you move up to the Madhyam and then the need or the Andolan becomes Avrohi, Da ma pa da 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 ma re sa. So when it takes the gamma re sa root, the same Gandhar moves its position and goes towards the Madhya. Sare ga 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 sa, and then comes the knee for connection. Andolan between Nisha Devat in the upper octave. Da 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 is the same as da, da. So this is the sphere of Darbari.